Yo, this your boy, Mr. Mina, representing one half of the group Partners in Crime, and you already know I'm in the building. Know the nation with my dog, Mo.
I got motherfucking Mr. Mina in the building. You hear me? PNC for life.
Yes, sir.
You know, I'm alumni. You know, I've been since day one. You hear me? I had tape cassettes. This right here, this is major for me. Thank you so much for coming. Even as we were talking about before the cameras came on, you know, you did a lot for the culture, bro. And even like you said right there, even a little something simple like, you know, allowing, you know, the relationship with BTY, like, that shit's special. You know what I'm saying? But that come from you showing love.
Right. I always use Youngin, bro. And the reason why I use Youngin is because Youngin is like, he was one of them younger cats that made me believe, like, you know, like when I stopped believing, you know, like, you come a time in music where you get like, man, fuck, man, this shit ain't for me no more, you know, okay, I meet this kid, and this kid has all of, he's still dreaming, like, you know what I'm saying, and he believe that shit, like, you know, I'm the best rapper, since the best rapper died, man, Slim was the best rapper, I'm the new soldier, so like, he really believed it, like, you know, he walk in front of everybody, and, you know, and just to see, you know, he had spoke that kind of life back into me to where I was like, damn, I was believing again, like, you know what I'm saying, like, oh, this real, like, you know, this stuff really can happen, and he was on his way, you know what I'm saying, you know, it's almost like, you know, balloon that's about to fly off and then somebody pop, you know, just bust it, you know what I'm saying, and they take all that out you, you know what I'm saying, so people probably don't know that, but yeah, that's some new stuff, that's probably something I just really exposed, but it, because of the stuff we was talking about, that kind of opened me up to
Well, that's at the end of the day, that's what it's about. That's why the culture is so special.
You know, my first artist that I did that with was Kango.
Come, bro.
And I'm 4 years older than Kango, so you know, Kango was, you know, when you're a teenager, a kid that's 19 compared to a kid that's 14, they're on just two different waves. Like, you know what I'm saying? So if I'm 18 years old, and Kango 14 years old. We not really hanging together. You know, like, we almost not peers because the stuff of folks, you know, a little early ninth grade and the guy that's about to graduate, it's kind of like they're on the world's, like, so he wasn't, like, really hanging buddies at the time. But I mentored him, you know. I told him from the beginning, like, I'm like, boy, your talent, man, going to the top. You know what I'm saying? We're gonna do something special, like, you know what I'm saying? And that young man believed in me, and we kind of, like, created this brand that we have to this day called Partners in Crime, like, you know what I'm saying? You know, which is a household name, especially in New Orleans, really the Southern region, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but come on now, I know you humble.
Yeah, but I'm on, saying, man. Like, I, you know, I'll be truthful too, you know, within the Southern region, like, we hold some pretty good strength. We tour those areas, like, constantly, you know, all these years later, we still kind of working, like, and going in all those different areas of the South, so, and somewhat Midwest, you know what I'm saying? But it's been a good run, bro.
No, for sure.
A good run.
You raised me. You know, they came a prime time when you would say to do something. Well, not even, you wouldn't say to do it, but because you rocked a certain way, I rocked a certain way.
Wow.
Yeah, I couldn't stop fucking with Jizzle. I couldn't. But don't get comfortable. I'm no real shit like
that. Right, real talk. Right.
Huh?
We had our influences too, you know, in hip hop, you know. This the whole thing. Like, they got people that raised us, Run DMC. You know, like, the reason that I rap, and the reason why I made the song I Got Gucci's was because they had a song called I Got My Adidas, and in 85, that I went to a concert with some older guys, they brought me to a Razor Hill concert, and I saw the power of hip-hop. I saw them say, put one shoe up in the whole arena, just, and I was just like, I won't do that. That's what I won't do.
Perfect.
Yeah, so when you say something raised you, I totally understand it, because you know, like, a lot of things happen in what you take in and what you believe and what you feel, what you get from it, and the emotions that it give you, like, it, you remember that.
100%.
Yeah, right. So, yeah, I totally feel that. I'm honored to say, you know, we was a part of that, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes I wish I could, I guess, be a better influence. You know, we was young, we was kids, so we did a lot of stuff.
I get it.
You know, we didn't know that music had as much influence as it had. We was just kids, you know? We talk about our environment, talking about what we doing with our partners, what we doing with the females, you know, how we rocking, how we, you know, so whatever the reality was, it was cool to make a song about it, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, I know we was talking earlier, you was asking, like, you know, how this Heron song, you know, how that came about. And like I said, I had a lot of partners that was getting loaded. I wasn't getting loaded, you know what I'm saying? But I saw the effect. So really, when we made the song, thinking that it'll make people say, I ain't gonna fuck with the hell.
Word?
Yeah. It sounded like we was inviting you because we was young, but we was thinking like, you got your throwing, got your spooky, got your throwing up, we thinking maybe people would be like, I ain't fucking
with
you.
No, you really did.
Yeah, but we thinking like, maybe if I take, because this is what we seen.
Come, bro, maybe if I like, tell you the real.
Yeah, maybe you'll leave it alone. Maybe. We thought that. Instead, it's like.
So nobody in the group fuck with that dope?
Well, Kango didn't need me to Kango, but Prime used to get loaded, you know, and all my other partners. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, I don't really want to put all those guys.
All my partners
was like.
How did you stay away from that?
I just was a leader, bro. Like, you know, my whole thing was like, I was too a dude that wanted to be on game so much that I wanted to know what was happening, that I felt like I had to stay sharp. Then I had a mama that, you know, my mom had me at a young age, but my mom had me at 14. So she was more like my sister, like, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, my pops is in jail, like, you know what I'm saying? My pops, you know, had a double life sentence in Angola, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, I'm just like, you know, just out here pretty much on my own, and the streets is what's teaching me. So if people on the streets telling me like, look, Mike, you gotta, you know, my mom was, like I said, only 14 years older than me. So guys that was mentoring me or trying to like give me game, so they was always looking out for me more like, man, your mom a good woman, you don't need to be out here. You know what I'm saying? I always was pushed away from the game, which made me know it wasn't really for me. Like, you know what I'm saying? Because for some level, I saw that people saw something else in me. You know, not that I was no lame dude, because everybody used to say, like, Mike, you got heart, like, you know what I'm saying? You got a lot of heart to be, you know what I'm saying? Leo, or whatever may be the case. So I was built up on one level, but then on another level, it was like, you better than that. So, you know, and then older people used to always say, you're going to be right where your daddy at. You're going to end up just like him. And, you know, I just didn't want that for myself. I just didn't want nobody to be able to tell me that's what my life going to be. Like, that's why I teach young brothers now about the power of the tongue. You know what I'm saying? What we speak, watch what we say. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, we speak things into existence. You know what I'm saying? Things at that level. So, that wasn't the coolest part. Like, you know what I'm saying? But it was a part of being young. That's why I could relate to these young artists that talk about popping pills and different things, because I understand that's the drug of choice for their time.
Yeah. So look, man, I wanted your opinion because I really, you know what I'm saying, value your opinion. And I don't like to put out negative energy, you know what I'm saying? So, like, sometimes I'm iffy about what I ask, but I ain't gonna lie, dog, when it comes to you, let's think about it. Not only have you been in it, like, you're a fucking veteran, you know what I'm saying? Right. You know, you so experienced, you got so much wisdom, so much knowledge, and you that cat who ain't trying to be on no shiesty shit. You really are sharing game and pulling people up and uplifting the city and really for the culture. That's what PNC about, and I'm gonna just let you know for me, my kids, and my family, you somebody who like I appreciate. I would like you to rub off on my kids. You know what I'm saying? I want my kids to see what, you know what I'm saying, love look like, and the way you and your wife are. You know, it's support. That's a beautiful thing. You do that with your kids too. Right. You know what I'm saying? So I have to say happy belated Father's Day.
Thank you, bro. You know, I'm a guy about law and principles to that level. You know, I'm not a perfect guy at all. But any mistake that I've made or any mistake that a person can call me out on and I can relate to it, I mean, like, you can make me understand I was wrong, I have no problem with being wrong and growing from it. But I'm a man about family, you know what I'm saying? Since we talking on tape, I want to put something real out on tape. You know, I got two older daughters, bro, and I got two younger daughters. I got a wife that have two kids, and I got two baby moms. Like, and I would like my daughters to know this, my oldest daughters. Like, you know, first of all, I love all my children equally the same. But you gotta understand, I can't be in every household, right?
Right.
So at a certain age in my life, you know, like everything happens in group. My dad been in jail for the majority of my life. So when I'm raising kids, I only know how to be a dad that I know how to be. I don't think they got a rule book to how to be whatever. You know, you just be it. Like, you know what I'm saying? People can show you things, but you know what I'm saying? It's on you to still play it out, right?
Hey.
So, you know, at a certain period of my life, man, I ran after rap. You know, I know when you're chasing this dream, sometimes you lose some things. Like, you know what I'm saying? So my two oldest daughters, like, you know, like, I just wanted them to know, like, you know what I'm saying? I wasn't in the household with them, but my love was always the same that it is for my family that I have now, like, you know what I'm saying, or whatever. It's never nothing different. Just I was chasing rap around this time, and just giving money ain't always enough. You know what I'm saying? So you be wanting your kids to know. So these are some of the mistakes that I've made that I like sharing with people, because I told you I'm an open book. So I'm to a level of like, you know what I'm saying? No, I done got better. I got a better understanding of what it is to be a father. I started learning like where my riches was really at. You know what I'm saying? Because I was chasing riches, but that wasn't really what made me rich. You know what I'm saying? What made me rich is family, the ones that you love, your bloodline, things to that level. And just being there when they need you, like, you know what I'm saying? Which I felt like I was a dad that was being there with all my kids as much as possible. But at the same time, they lived in another household, so I couldn't juggle all that. You know what I'm saying? So I just wanted them to know I love them, because sometimes, they, you know, you can say it, but when you can express it to the world or let everybody know, you know, they get a better understanding, like, damn, you know, maybe I'm just looking at this guy in a certain way, you know what I'm saying?
Fact. You know what's crazy is I just went and picked up my middle baby. You know what I'm saying? I got 5 kids. You know what I mean? 3 biological, 2 step. But at the end of the day, I relate. And I ain't start making babies till I was in Mississippi. I was in the Army for 10 years. And
interesting life, bro.
For sure.
Yeah, I'm just listening to it. It sounds interesting, but go ahead. I'm listening.
I have a son that I'm raising long distance, and it hurts, you know what I'm saying? But by you saying stuff like that and doing that, I soak up game from people like you, so that helps me too. Like, you're right, like we do need to express that love when we get the opportunity to. And you do that so much, dog. Like, you the epitome of who I want to be, you know what I'm saying?
That's respect, brother.
No, real shit.
That's respect. I'm just telling you that it's an honorable thing. I mean, I'm not, like I said, nobody's perfect, bro. I don't even try to go for perfect. I'm just trying to become a better version of myself as I grow older. So if I'm mature and I know if what I did yesterday was wrong, you know what I'm saying? I just got to make it right today. Like, you know what I'm saying? I can't go back on yesterday, but I can be a better version today. So, you know, that's where I'm at. The stuff you see on Instagram with me and my family, bro, be genuinely like where I'm at.
Right.
You know, people see me out, they be like, man, you really with you, girl. No, I ain't just did that for no gram. Like, we was taking pictures. If I was to whip out books to show you album cover books, me and my wife been taking pictures, like, you know what I'm saying? Since she used to hang with me and all my partners. Like, we all going, like, you know, because I like hanging with her.
Right.
So she always was my partner. So it ain't really hard, you know what I'm saying, to hang. We go out, laugh, real joke. You know, I be saying, look, she fine. Like, I be playing, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, so be cool
first,
like that.
The first time I caught you in public when I was grown, because I seen you when I was younger a couple times, but when I was grown at Republic or one of them clubs or something like that, you and her were together. Y'all were talking it out together.
Right.
It wasn't for no nothing. It was you and her. You was gonna be in the club, she was gonna be in the club. And y'all really vibe, like y'all was laughing together and stuff, and like that's a beautiful thing. You really set the tone, you know what I'm saying, when it comes to anything. You know, but I love that about you, dog. You know what I'm saying? So, like I said, I really was aiming to pick your motherfucking brain today, brother. Because I know there's so much fucking history, wisdom, love in there. Like, you know, and I know there's some pain, too.
Yeah. You saw me just express some pain.
Hey.
I said that it feels good.
That's what I know.
And I ain't the crying type, but I'm passionate about my family, I'm another dude for my family, like, you know, something I let you go with on me, I'm a monster and you behind them, like, you know what I'm saying? It's like, you might call me a bitch ass, whatever, you know what I'm saying? But you
and
call my wife
slide.
A bitch ass, you might lose your life behind that. But me, I'm letting it go. You know, you disrespect my daughters a certain kind of way, I'm 5150 behind me, you know, like, it's just another person, so... Yeah, bro, I'm passionate about that. That's you know what I'm saying? That's with anybody, so.
And that's how it should be, real talk, right. You heard me? Like, I've been seeing what you've been doing with the clothes and shit.
Right.
You know, and I know you've been kind of, like, working on it, but right now, it's available.
Right, yeah.
So talk to me about it.
Man, look, Shop Graffiti, man. That's Shop, and I spell graffiti, GRAFFETETE, right? You know, a little hip-hop version of it. It's like almost like short for graphic tee, and graffiti, you know what I'm talking about? So it's like some little rap
sweat.
Shit, like,
yeah.
So it's called Shop Graffiti, man, you know what I'm saying? You can go there, you can get them Run That PNC shirts. This is one of the shirts I got on right here. You know, just representing the culture to the fullest, you know what I'm saying? We all know it out, you know what I'm saying? So go on the site, check it out. Or you can DM me if you follow me on Instagram. That's MREMEANA_PNC. You know what I'm saying? Just follow me on Instagram and You know, the link's in the bio, you know what I'm saying? Or you can DM me, you know what I'm saying? And get it popping.
But like I said, I was gonna peek your brain, Buku. You hear me? But at the end of the day, I'm so much of a fan. Let's talk about what you been putting your motherfucking time into.
Well, since Young passed, you know, I wasn't really fucking with music. You know, that was, like I said, went out of me. But I just felt like, his cousin talked to me, you know what I'm saying? He was like just telling me like, man, like you're doing a disservice to the city by not really working with these artists.
Thanks.
So what happened was I went somewhere and I ran into Walt Dizzy, D.I. from the squad. And he was like, man, why don't you come work with me on this project? I'm trying to get back in the game, bro. I feel like if I had you, I'm going somewhere. So, you know, I liked him as a person, so I kind of checked his music out. I gave him my opinion. He was open-minded to what we was talking about. He said, why don't you see if you can get a beat from Black and Mild for me? Boom, I called Black and Mild. I said, man, bring Dizzy over here, man. Brought him over there. It was on from there. Black did a beat for him, which is the single that he's working right now called I Ain't Lying. And we started doing a Skipping Dizzy project because they wanted to keep the Uptown Downtown thing going. So that's a project that I'm working on. So what I brought to the table was like, look, bro, instead of just being Skipping Dizzy, let's bring artists together. Let's bring this city together through this project. You know, Skip was like, we're gonna name it Uptown Downtown, one word, like not like
right.
Two words.
I like that.
Like we all together, right? So, you know, we do that. And, you know, so we just start putting songs together. So I'm like kind of airing off, it being an A&R throughout the project. Like, we need to get this person with a feature. We need to get this person on a song. And just mixing stuff that I think will make dope music. You know, mixing young artists with older artists. You know, I told Skip and I'm like, y'all could do this song, but let's do the hook. Let him lead the song. We want his, you know, energy on, like, we want him to lead it. And then y'all compliment him. And then some songs is like, Skip, you did the best hook. You know, we just getting the best of the best, putting it on the song. We in the studio, who got the best hook? Who got an idea to be hit? Oh, that's dope, let's go with that. And, you know, just piecing it together. So, they have a great project coming out, bro. It's the first of many things that we about to do in the city. And that's where I'm at. I'm just back juiced up. I'm back focused. And, you know, I got business set up with them now. So now I'm partnering with my people, Ike. He got a company called My People Gotta Eat. You know, I bring artists his way. Like, I tell artists, for me to work with you, you gotta take that class. So, because you gotta learn the business. Man. You gotta learn the business because it's that much harder for me to work with you. So now, when you come back and you have some business understanding, when I start talking to you certain things, you're like, yeah, I know what you mean. Okay, I got that straight. Like, now we doing business. So they gotta take that class. Then, you know, we jam up. I'm working with Devious, you know what I'm saying? Devious kind of like make sure that everybody, you know, the clearances thing, you know, all that nature. Then, you know, Vertical, you know, with Big Daddy, you know what I'm saying? We're sending, you know, if you got a nice single, we send, you know, we just trying to make business here in New Orleans, like to a level where it makes sense and showing people how to get money like now, you know what I'm saying? And once they do that, you know, some of the crime gonna go down because people gonna be looking like, bro, look, I'm about to, let me do a song together. Some of that beef ain't gonna be worth it because everybody gonna see how to get a bag. And if they can see that they can work together and get it, it's gonna change some things here, you know? So I'm just trying to get it back to the early 90s when we had a lot of fun with all the artists kind of work with each other. I'm trying to get them to start doing shows together so that they can see the power in numbers. So that's where I'm at. That's my whole focus right now. My whole focus is in this little gumbo pot, get this thing popping and kind of make something really happen for some real. And I feel like I owe that to my dude Young because he was an inch from going there. And, you know, so if I could do it for, you know, the city and set it up, that's what we talked about. That's some of the things that he was saying. And if I pop, bro, I'm coming, we're going to set it up with everybody. You know, we're going to put all the real niggas on. I'm like, right. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just going to keep it going. Like, all right, that's what dude wanted. I agreed. That's what I wanted at the same time. So now I'm back involved. And that's what I'm looking to do, bro. Before we get off, because I always forget to tell people this. Listen, bro, me and my wife got a life insurance company, right? Where we help people get life insurance, bro. You know what I'm saying? And I think people don't take this serious enough. Like, you know what I'm saying? We need to make sure. Listen, I'm going to leave y'all with this. When we was younger, grandma didn't pay no other bill but her life insurance because, listen, we know our birth date, but we don't know our death date. We don't know when that date, when God gonna call us home or when we gotta go. So with that being said, we need to make sure we got some kind of insurance on our life, even if it's just to get buried. Because that's a lot of hardship that you leave on the families blowing suppers, this and that, and that, and that. You know what I'm saying? And you put people set back. Some people never even got back life right because they had to pay for their mom's funeral or somebody's funeral that they really didn't have the money to do. And they made loans and they did all these kind of different things. And these people's life is still in a shamble behind somebody that died 10, 15 years ago. You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, we need to get that. So, man, get at me. DM me, you know what I'm saying? DM my wife and then T-Title 504. You know, we helping families, and we also showing people how to invest their money for long-term savings. So when you get to be an older man and you want to retire, you have enough money, like, put away that you can actually live off of, you know what I'm saying, for the rest of your life. So, yeah, let's sit down and get educated on those type of things. I think that make all the difference in the world.
You're making the community a better place.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And shout out to American Trail, you know what I'm saying? She's giving a few keys out. I want to say this on camera. I feel like you've been deserve a key to the city. And I'm going to say that because whether this camera on or off,
right,
whether you on IG or not, like, you for the culture, you for the city, you for your family, you know what I'm saying? You take care of a lot of, you got a lot of mouths to feed, and you do that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But not only that, you done came a long way, dog.
Right. Yeah, real talk. I said the same thing. I'm like, you know, Kango did the boycott bowl, right? That was an event that he put on with partnered with some other friends, Travis, you know, Lauren Dean. They partnered up and did the boycott bowl, bro. And, you know, 60,000, you know, people, whatever, came out. They raised 57, whatever, you know, $1,000 and gave to Noah. You know what I'm saying? Some people be like, man, that money didn't get... Hey, bro, I don't know. I'm sorry. If we did it the wrong way, we apologize for that. All we was trying to do was something for the right cause.
Hey.
We did it. So I think that the mail came out. She saw the effect of what happened. You know, we got a proclamation, but I thought we should have got a key to the city because we really spent out of our own pocket for other things. Like, besides that, we did this thing called Saving Our Youth Foundation.
Right.
It
wasn't, that's what I was talking about.
It wasn't a nonprofit. It was just me and Kango down there going to schools and just talking and putting on talent, bringing the hottest artists in the city to these schools and mentors and people just kind of talking to these kids to try to, like, save as many as we possibly could. And we did that out of our own pocket. We didn't have no cameras and all this kind of stuff behind it. We just did it. The people who was there who really knew, because we didn't have social media, IG, right, and all that kind of stuff at the time. So, you know, the things that we did was just from the heart, like, you know what I'm saying? And stuff we still do from the heart. But, you know, I guess in time, you know what I'm saying, people are recognized. I just be looking at certain things, I'd be like, damn, like, you know what I'm saying? It's not that I'm even tripping to get it, but damn, like, then I get it, sometimes you still be looking like, well, damn, like, you know where they at? Like, what you gotta do, like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
no,
you
for
know,
sure though.
You know, cause we talking about for the city. I ain't talking about making records. I'm just talking about
for our community.
For the community.
Yeah. And that's you know what I'm saying, that's what draw people to PNC too, bro. You know what I'm saying? Y'all do a lot of that. So I definitely gotta say thank you for coming, you heard me.
Right.
This shit, like I said, when I say it's a win for the city. It's a win for Northern Nation, but it's a win for New Orleans. Anytime, you know what I'm saying, you're able to get your roses, you know what I'm saying? I feel like
I appreciate that. Yeah.
Yeah, I know, but for sure you deserve that. You done earned that. Right. You know what I'm saying? A couple things before we go though, I definitely wanna ask, is there anybody in the city right now who you got your eye on, who you bumping, who you really enjoy? Because I know you got a unique taste, you heard me, but real talk, anybody you really enjoying right now?
I like a lot. I like the little dude, Cutter Black.
Jay Black?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Cutter, yeah, Jay Black, yeah, I like him. I like Danny Hollis. I like Jay Jones, bro. I like 6dot. I like Jamie Montana. It's just a lot of, like, Hollywood King. They got some dudes on the West Bank, I heard. I saw them in a concert, I can't remember their name, but they gave a great show, bro. I don't know, I like a lot of stuff. I like OG stuff, I like the shit that Fume just dropped. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
bro. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, I'm liking a few Curry Cinnamon little jams. You know, I'm just the same artist that I've been. I love hip hop. So I like the artist. I like the city. I like the culture of the city. I like a lot of people that's just doing it, just trying to come up, bro. You know what I'm saying? I just like the whole essence of what we got going on.
Last question. Why is Know the Nation important to the culture?
Well, I've been watching your platform, bro, and you're not biased. Anybody that's worthy, like, you know what I'm saying? I don't see that you're just doing anybody. It's like the people that you kind of been interviewing and the things that you've been putting on your platform is kind of people that's worthy of it. And I think that that's what make a brand a brand. If anybody could just jump on me, you know, some people be like, man, you know, just interviewing and everybody. I'm like, it kind of don't make your brand worth nothing because you're not talking about letting nobody get a check for all that they really respect. It is almost like you're making a story. So you take the, you know, the authentic side of what it's supposed to be based on and just made it more like, you know, like, I got somebody on here. You know what I'm saying? Have some people on there that people like and respect. And I think that's what you take pride in. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, artistry, you know, I remember you reaching out, man, I need to get Jay Jones on. Like, you're like, you doing, you know, it's almost like you reaching for the artist you want to put on.
Like, he's coming next.
You see what I'm saying? So, I'm glad that that happened.
From you. Thank you. Yeah. That's the beauty in what you do and what you offer the culture. So, let me talk my shit for a little quick second. I ain't gonna keep you too long, but I want you to know something. I go by Mo, you heard me? They call me the backbone of the 504. You know what I'm saying? But you gotta respect the other body parts. You know what I'm saying? I feel like you the heart of this bitch. You heard me? I feel like baby the brain of this bitch. Right. I feel like we got different, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, functions. Different parts that make it all work. Right.
And so when I tell you it's a win, like my grandma got dementia, but I done told her 4 times today you coming to this bitch. You understand?
Right.
I fuck with you.
Speak that shit, bro.
Thank you so much for coming, dog. Like, real stuff. Whatever you ever need from me, it's never a question.
Y'all hear Mo, huh? Yeah, I know. Whatever, he said, call on. So when I call and I come back and I say, man, Mo wasn't here, he ain't answer the phone.
He tripping, you know that.
Mo had me sitting outside for 40 minutes waiting on him to get in here. I better hit him, Mo. Like, man, I'm here, you know. But nah, it's all love, bro. I like what Mo's doing, you know what I'm saying? Keep supporting this platform, bro, because I'm going to keep watching. Y'all stay tuned in. Yo, this your boy, Mr. Mina, represent one half of the group Partners in Crime, and you already know I'm in the building, Nola Nation, with my dog, Mo. Thank you.